89.3. This is the last stop on the 4 train. I'm your host, Thomas Simmons, on the September 27th. And tonight's program is celebrating the life of the great John Coltrane, who celebrated a 93rd birthday on Monday. And in the studio with me, have a special guest as well. And this man needs no introduction to Atlanta jazz, because he was involved in a lot of facets of jazz in Atlanta. Speaking of the brother John Armwood, what's
hey,
up, John?
Hey, Tommy. It's a pleasure to be here with you, and I enjoy your show each and every Friday evening. Even though I don't call in every week, you groove. So it's just like, it's great to be here. It's been a long time since I've been in the studios of WRFG.
No doubt, man. So, you know, this special occasion, man. So talk about Train, brother. You know.
Well, John Coltrane, to me, was an emotional connection to jazz. That's what he represented to me in my teen years. I remember I was like 14 when he died in 1967. And I really didn't know who he was, but the way everybody talked about him, he was like somebody special. So I started searching out his music, and I really got into it by the time I was around 15, 16. I remember getting The Best of John Coltrane, His Greatest Years on Impulse. That was the first John Coltrane album I got. And I got taken in by two tunes, Naima, which was kind of out,
great
and
tune.
Also Softly As in a Morning Sunrise.
Off of Live at the Village Vanguard, ain't it?
Yeah. That was the Naima. It was Live at the Village Vanguard again. And then the Impression, I think Softly in the Morning Sunrise was the session that made Impressions. I can't remember which of the two records that came off of that, two records from that session. I'm forgetting all the details of those recordings. No, we were young, man. We didn't mess that stuff up. But now,
yeah, no doubt. So we started the show, John, by the way, with two selections. We heard John take it from an Atlantic recording titled Giant Steps. And we heard the composition of Cousin Mary, who just passed away a few weeks ago. And she was like 92 years old, John Coltrane's cousin. And that historic composition features John Coltrane on tenor, Tommy Flanagan at the piano, Paul Chambers on bass, Art Taylor on drums. Classic piece of music. We started out with a blowing session on a prestige date titled Willin' and Dillin', with John Coltrane, Paul Quinichet, Frank West, Mal Waldron, Doug Watkins, and Art Taylor. And we heard the composition of Things Ain't What They Used to Be. Yes. We're going to continue. We're going to come back with more conversation. Right, John?
Oh, of course. I mean, this is like a joy. The music of John Coltrane runs so deep in our generation and I guess the two generations before us. I mean, he was just such an influence on jazz. It was a musical influence, but it was also a spiritual influence. And I remember, for me, it changed my life. I remember going out and picking up John Coltrane records, going to see tributes to him, going to see Pharoah Sanders at the East in Brooklyn. And everything was about John Coltrane back in those days, from late 60s to early 70s. Coltrane was almost like a god to some people. Some people worshiped him. There was a church.
You know that. In San Francisco.
Yeah.
So we're going to get back into the music. And number in the studio is area code 404-523-8989. We're sitting here with Brother John Armwood, jazz historian. And this is the last stop on the 4 train.
Talk about that.
After this, I'm gonna play Alabama.
Yeah, that was cool.